One welcomes you all to the session on corporate decision making in a global environment, lessons for budding managers. As we all know that in today's environment, hoarding knowledge ultimately erodes your power. If you know something very important, the way to get power is by actually sharing it. A lecture is an occasion when you numb one end to benefit the other. At our dais, emphasis is given not only on making you academically brilliant, but true leaders and team players, thus preparing you for the real-life corporate world. This is done by inviting people from industries and top institutions to provide valuable information to our students. Before moving ahead, I would like to tell you about the topic. In today's business environment, there is a sustained pressure for companies to maximize productivity in order to be competitive in the marketplace. Many businesses are moving a variety of activities, such as manufacturing and product development, to countries with low labor cost. The resulting global organizations need to structure themselves so that they can effectively manage operations across numerous locations. And corporate decision making is one activity that can be approached in so many ways. It involves making a choice to alter some existing conditions. It is choosing one course of action in preference to the others. Corporate decision making is successful as long as there is a glue to bind the organization together in the form of charismatic leaders or an organizational culture that values coherence and imposes stability. Once any of these conditions are removed, then the organizations fall into a self-defeating trap wherein the process of corporate decision making is impaired, leading to the loss of competitiveness of the company. This is just few insights from our side, and we look forward to get an exposure about what the best of the brains think about this. And for that, we have Professor Dr. J.K. Goyal. We welcome you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor and privilege to introduce you to an eminent thinker, an expert par excellence in the field of economics, Professor Dr. J.K. Goyal. Sir is an educational administrator of repute. Sir inspires his students, motivates the faculty members, and has the capability of taking everyone along with him. Currently, sir is an advisor in Jagan Institute of Management Studies, Rohini. He has been associated with GYMS since 2005. Earlier, he was the director of RDIRS and has been successfully associated with this organization since 1995. And sir had also been the stepping stone when Rukmini Devi Group of Institutions put forward their foundation as school. He is also a member of the Academic Advisory Council of RDIRS. He has been the public interest director of the Delhi School Exchange. He started his professional career as a lecturer in Delhi University. Sir had graduated in economics honors from Punjab University, where he stood first in the university and was awarded the gold medal in economics. Professor Dr. J.K. Goyal has done his master's in economics from Delhi School of Economics, University of Delhi. He has done his PhD from the Faculty of Commerce and Business. University of Delhi. He has over 4 decades of teaching experience both at undergraduate as well as postgraduate levels. He has presented papers at various national and international seminars and has written several articles. His main areas of interest are macroeconomics management and business environment. He is a keen sportsman and a trekker par excellence. He loves listening to Sufi music and he has a wonderful sense of humor. Sir, we are really fortunate to have you with us today. Now I request Dean Academics, Dr. Anshu Locher, to kindly felicitate Professor Dr. J.K. Goyal. Without any further ado, I would request sir to kindly open the forum for the session.
Hello, hello, can you hear me? Okay, can you see me? Fine, it's always nice to hear very good words about you early in the morning, particularly when they are spoken by such lovely girls. So, I wish my wife were hearing it. Because wives do not realize how great their husbands are. She wouldn't trust me for buying half a kg of potatoes only. That is the kind of level which I had at 8 a.m. At 9:30, I am being told how great you are. Koi log kehte hai na, swarg upar hai, narak niche hai, sab kuch yahi hai. 8 baje main narak mein tha. So, well, feel, first of all, I've been bluntly told that 11 o'clock sharp I have to finish. And I like that. Fair enough. Feel free to talk to me. Feel free to intercept. Ask questions. Because the deal between me and your director has been, the more you make my life uncomfortable, the larger the pay packet that I'll carry from here. Is that clear? So make my life uncomfortable. Ask questions. Don't worry about those marshals sitting over there. Internal assessment ke number kaat lungi. Agar yahan se hila, wahan se hila. Jo puchna hai, khula ke puchhiya. Right? Okay. Let's come back to this. Will someone be running? Okay. Yes, yes, yes. I'll just... Next, please. Next. Yeah. The lecture plan is simple. A. Why do we have to make decisions? You all know the answer. But I'll quickly go through that. Second part of my lecture will be, yeah, what are the unique features of the present global environment? We use the word so often. Globalization, liberalization, privatization. But what is unique about globalization in present context? And the third would be the one, general skills that you can always take from here. I do not have specific skills to offer you. Skills will depend upon the circumstances that you face. But I'll give you certain general skills which are always handy. That is the purpose of this, an hour and a half of interaction with you. Fine. Let's take the first one. Why do we have to make decisions? Simple. By now, all of you have done one course in managerial economics. We all know that there is always a mismatch between desires and resources. Desires are always higher than, more than the resources. Finite resources, infinite desires. So, naturally, there is a term all of you must have known, a term called trade-off. What does trade-off mean? Simple term. In terms of Bollywood dialogue, I want. Chunni Babu, kuch khane ke liye, kuch paane ke liye, kuch khona padta hai. Kuch paane ke liye, kuch khona padta hai. That is trade-off. Nothing else. So, which one to give up? Which one to take? And then of course, at the corporate level, you will find that a problem comes to which there are four solutions. There are multiple solutions. If there are four solutions, you can't adopt all four. You have to pick up one. So, which three to give up and which one to pick up? That is decision making. So, management is nothing other than a skill having decision making. Remember, you are not specialists. You are not working at the shop floor. You are not working in the accounts department, so to say. If you are a management executive, people expect you to take decisions which they may not be able to find out. You can get inputs from them, but who has to finally decide? You people. Fine? So, and this is, life offers alternatives, one thing. Second thing is that since our desires are unlimited, but limited resources we have to do with, so we have to somewhere compromise. That is why decision making is required. In fact, sometimes we say, our religious leaders say, Paramatma bada dayalu hai. God is great. Bhai Paramatma dayalu hota. With unlimited desires, he should have given us unlimited resources. Koi MBA nahi karni padti. If resources had been unlimited, why do you have to trade off? That is why you have to. Fine. Second part is, next please. What is unique about, because remember, there have been industrial revolutions, there have been globalization phases in economic history in the past also. But in this, two or three things I found very important in this phase of globalization. One is the pace of technological improvement. This phase, I will put it from 1970 onwards, the information technology phase. So about 50 years. But if you look at it within our lifetime, even if you are not as senior as me, you will find that so many changes are occurring. The kind of technology that you were using, say, 5 years ago, and now, there's a sea change. Those who have done BCA or those who have some knowledge of computers, you must be knowing this gentleman called Moore. Mr. Moore said he predicted that after every 18th month, what happens? Computing performance doubles, and this he says will continue for the next 40 years. And this he said long back, and it's still continuing. As you know, in about computers, you know, technological, there's a well-known phrase that you buy a computer today in the morning, you install it in the afternoon, by evening it becomes obsolete. That is the kind of, this was not there in previous times of globalization. You have to have, the lesson from this is you have to have an updated knowledge of, it's like riding a tiger. As long as you're riding it, you're safe. Once you dismount it, it will eat you. So that is something for this generation to take care, continuously updating. Never ever think that if you are 18-20 batch, to 30 April 2020 ko padhna likhna band, naukriyan lag jayengi. Trust me, once you get the job, your reading will be much more than what you are doing today. Technological, only thing is the classroom environment will not be there, but the process of learning will continue. Is that clear? Next is, of course, this is what I was telling you. Next, please. One was late 18th, 19th and 17th. This is, I said, this is what I'm talking about, microcredit. Next, please. Yeah, this is interesting. If you have done, or even if you have not done it, you know, if we talk about the production, or how does production take place? Production takes place when certain inputs combine and they create a, produce an output. These inputs can be classified into various categories, steel, raw steel, rubber, petrol, or seeds. We normally classify them into two broad categories, labor and capital, right? Some of you must have done or will be doing something called production function. Output is a function of labor, capital, and technology, right? So, all output takes place with the help of machines and men. When I say men, women are included. So, this is what output takes place. Now, the point is that I'm making. Look at this. The economists were very inquisitive about this. That suppose if the output has grown by 7%. GDP growth rate, I hope you understand these terms, that what was produced last year Suppose 100 kilograms of maize was produced. So this time 107 kilograms of maize has been produced. 7% more. How has it been happening? Why has it happened? Either you have might have employed more workers, labor must have increased, or you must have used more capital, a better tractor or something, or both. Fine. Now, earlier on, there were no statistical techniques, econometric techniques we call it, to isolate what is the contribution of labor and what is the contribution of capital in this 7%. Now there are statistical techniques, packages, softwares are there. You can isolate. Now in a typical country, what was found? Suppose a country grows by 7%, they found that labor's share, capital share is 2% of that. Machines have contributed only 2% of that. Another 2% was contributed by workers. That is only 4%. Baki 3% kahan se aa gaya? Total to 7% hua. 3% kahan se aa gaya? Neither you have increased labor nor capital. Dono ki cost padti hai. Ye 3% technological improvement se aaya. The same worker is now smarter. And technological improvement doesn't cost anything. There was a gentleman called Robert Solow. He first propounded this. He says in the entire growth, the larger the residual, Solow residual kehte hain hum ise. Isme Solow residual kitna hai? 3%. Because 4% has come due to increase in either labor or capital. Today's economic model or modern growth is more in terms of the third, Solow residual. They say, companies say, there is no smartness. Isme aapki kya smartness hui agar aapne jyada workers laga ke ya jyada capital laga ke jyada output dikha diya. Capital bhi cost thi, worker bhi. Smartness kis mein hai? Technological improvement. Aap smart ban jao. These companies these days are hiring people who are who are smarter this way, which larger productivity, Solow residual, jis company ka zyada hoga, wo survive karegi. Is that clear? That is why this is unique. The pace of technological improvement, and second thing is the Solow residual. Technological improvement translated into companies' growth. Or larger perspective mein kahun, nation's growth. Simple. Third thing. Yeah. Next, please. Another thing. Earlier on, information was restricted to big industrial houses only. Ambani knew more than, say, me or a small manufacturer. He knew which technique is coming up where. He has a larger access to information because information used to cost a lot. What is happening with this new IT culture? Information is not costing anything. Access to information is there with everyone, irrespective of big or small, medium or large, which means the earlier advantage of being large, which existing companies used to take, that is not available. That is why you will find that in this last 30 years, the first generation entrepreneurs have grown much faster than the traditional big industrial houses, which was not possible earlier on. So this is another, could you get this or not? Please feel free to ask questions. Are you getting it what I'm saying? Three things: the speed with which technology is changing, second thing, technological improvement translated into greater productivity without, this is very important, greater productivity without increasing either labor or capital. And the third thing, the ease of dissemination of knowledge has given us what we call a level playing field to the small, big, medium, large. So that disadvantage is gone. Next, please. This is another thing. Yeah, please. We are talking about that the knowledge, because of the, I distinctly remember that I had to, one day in hostel 40 years ago, I give you a simple example, you know, 40 years ago in hostel, we were just discussing about one small thing, that what is the difference between Shia and Sunni. And none of us knew that. Next day morning, I was in Delhi School of Economics studying there. I went there for half a day, I searched. Because it was all economics books, I searched an encyclopedia of Islam, Cambridge. And from there I read, and it took me 3 p.m., 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. to understand the difference. About 15 days ago, me and wife were talking about, we had a Muslim friend. She said to my wife that we have gone on a Hajj. We are going on Hajj. And there is another term called Umrah. Umrah is kind of smaller Hajj. Jaise Mata Jagran and Mata Giji Chauki. Jagran sari raat ka Chauki tin kante di. To wohi hai yahan. And my wife immediately picked up the, phir Google auntie kis liye. Ekdam dekha, within 3 minutes she told me, this is the difference between Hajj and Umrah. It took me 6 hours to find out the difference between Shia and Sunni. That is what I mean, ease of dissemination of information. It spreads so fast. It can have its negatives. Aajkal jitna jo hai na, fake news se aur usse jo problems aa rahi hai, I am not touching that, but always technology has positives and negatives. I use the word information. Right. Will that be alright? I take your point, I'll get it right. Yeah, that's what I mean. Information. That I said information is not costing much at all. It is easy and cost free. So what is happening today? Now another thing is happening is there is only the initial cost. In IT revolution, there is an initial cost of creating something. Duplication costs are absolutely zero. So what will happen? The larger the volumes you will serve, the greater the size of the market, the lower will be your per unit cost. So costs will always be falling as you keep on selling more and more. Because initially jo kharch kar diya, duplication costs are nothing. This is something which was not happening in the traditional production system. So these are the 4 points which make this current phase of industrial revolution a unique, or sorry, liberalization or globalization, they make it unique. Fine, is that clear? Let's come to the final part, that is, what is it? Next, please. Yeah, this part is interesting. As I said, I cannot give you a cut and dried solution. When you go out to the real world, ऐसे जैसे कहते हैं ना, जब असली कुरुक्षेत्र में जाओगे, जंग के मैदान, things will be quite different from what we have learnt in the classroom comforts. There, your own skill, your own judgment, your spur of the moment reaction, all those things will be required. Fine. What at best we can impart to you is, there are certain checklists. I'll tell you about 5 of them. You can always check them. before taking any final decision. Now, in this, next please. Yeah, I am not spending any time on that. All HR professionals and aapko jo na orientation mein bhi ye sari baatein batai gayi hongi ki ek minute. Is pe koi time kharch karne ki to zarurat nahi hai na. Maine is pe time kharch karna chahta ki always act, don't react. You should be a good listener. Then only you should speak. There is always a better way. There is always a advantage in listening to the other side quietly. Do teen chance. Ek to zyada dusre aadmi se sunoge aap. Number one, you will have a longer time to frame your answer. Usko bolne do bhabhe bhabhe bhabhe. Apna answer aaram se. Second thing, chances hai ke jab dusra aadmi zyada bolega to kahin na kahin galti karega. You capitalize on that immediately. So it's always a good way to be listening is always good. That is what we say. Clear? I'm not spending any time. Let's go to the specific things that I want to tell you. Number one. Yeah. Yes, one way of looking at things could be, ये एक general approach बता रहा हूँ, इससे आप जो ना सारे exams भी दे सकते हो, और interviews भी, और बाद में जब practical life में जाएं तब, you can adopt a clinical approach. What is the clinical approach? You go to a doctor, you tell the doctor, doctor, I have a tummy ache, पेट दर्द है. What will be the doctor asking you the first question? What is the problem? आपने problem बतानी tummy ache है. Number one, you should find out what is the problem which you are facing at the moment. And it is always helpful if you pick up your diary and note down certain points in this clinical approach. What is the problem? जो आपको question आते हैं ना, describe such and such thing. When sir or ma'am is writing, describe, इसका मतलब आपको describe ही करना है. What are the causes of growing population? Second question क्या है? How or why has it arisen? Why has this problem come in my factory or at my workplace? Try to find out the reasons. Naturally. You will say, ye khaya tha, wo khaya tha, he'll try to find out. The third thing is, of course, he'll suggest you the remedy, prescription. Agar usse pura pata chal jaya tha, nahi to test wagera karwayega, wo alag baat. Third thing is, you try to rectify it. Fine. This is a three-stage approach. If you get cured, matter ends there. Chances are, you will not get cured. Then what will happen? Then there are two more steps. What are those two more steps? What could be those two more steps? Yeah? No? Anyone? ये बाद की बात है, पांचवा है. बिल्कुल ठीक लो. उससे पहले, why has the previous remedy failed? चेंज करके भी जाओगे वो क्या करेगा? आपने पुराने टेस्ट दिखा दिए, ठीक है, आपने चेंज कर दिया डॉक्टर, ठीक है, वो पुराने टेस्ट देखेगा, पुरानी रेमेडी, पुरानी वो करे. व्हेन ही सीज द प्रीवियस मेडिसिन्स एंड प्रिस्क्रिप्शंस, व्हाट इज ही ट्राइंग टू डू? ही इज ट्राइंग टू फाइंड आउट व्हाई द फर्स्ट प्लान हैज फेल्ड. प्लान ए क्यों फेल हुई? यू ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट दैट रीजन एंड देन ऑफकोर्स सजेस्ट प्लान B. This is called the clinical approach. If you use it steps-wise, it looks simple. But if you use it step-by-step, you will find that gradually solutions will appear. Fine? There's another way of, more scientific way of saying this clinical approach. Let us see that. Next, please. Yeah. Oh, before I go to the other approach, another thing. that whenever you suggest solution, does anyone know, does you know the concept of lead time? Let me tell you, lead time simply means the time gap between forecasting an event and the time when it is actually happening. Say, suppose today you say you are working in a Hyundai Motors showroom in Delhi, and say on 1st of October or 1st of November, you tell your boss that Dhanteras is around and we are expecting that 70 cars will be sold on that day from our showroom. 1st November ko aap bata rahe ho, 3 November ko Dhanteras hai. Hyundai Motors, aapke inventory mein sirf 30 cars padi hai, 70 bikengi. Hyundai Motors ka plant hai Chennai mein. Now, if you are telling it on 1st of November, you are forecasting an event which is going to happen on 3rd. So, what is the lead time? 2 days. First of all, could you understand the concept of lead time? Lead time is the time back between the day you forecast and the day the event actually happens. Because we all know that in management, this is no good management that you tackle a position, tackle a problem when it actually comes. We are also always taught what? We are taught that we should always forecast the problems and take preemptive action. My point is, the point that I want to take, the longer the lead time, the better will be the outcome of your strategy. Try to forecast it longer. As I said in this example, if you are saying from on 1st of November, you are telling your manager that we needed 70 cars on 3rd, and in 2 days, 40 cars cannot come from Chennai unless they are airlifted. That is not viable. So you are losing out on those 40 customers which want to buy a car on a particular auspicious day. That is what I am trying to do. The longer the lead time in your forecast, this is one strategy, that always take a long-term perspective, long-term, you can say, vision of things that are going to happen. That is, try to foresee trouble much in advance. Is that clear? Next, please. Yeah, we always talk about scientific analysis, that because many a time, you will, whenever teachers call you for presentations or questions, many times you use the word, "Ma'am, sir, I feel this is the answer. I feel." No. Those feelings, leave it to your parents, your boyfriend, girlfriend, whosoever you have crush on. Aajkal bahut se terms aa gaye hain. Blind date, crush, Tinder. मुझे तो कल वाइफ ने बताया Tinder भी कोई चीज है. Anyway, so what we have, that is, well, scientific analysis can be of two ways. This is very important for you to understand, that scientific analysis can either be in normative terms. Normative analysis means when we try to say what should be, what ought to be the ideal thing. Normative deals with ideal. Adarsh kya hona chahiye company ka, ya ghar ka, ya parivar ka, jo bhi. Positive analysis talks about the given current situation and within this situation, what is the best possible solution. I think this would be clearer if I give you a small caselet. Hurry up, please. Yeah. Read it. I can take a glass of water then. राइट सो नीतीश कुमार जी का फेवरेट सब्जेक्ट था कि मुझे जो है ना नशाबंदी करनी है बिहार में, लेकर इज ए स्टेट सब्जेक्ट, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट करती है. नाउ ही कॉल्स द मीटिंग इन विच हेल्थ एंड वेलफेयर मिनिस्टर कम्स, अनदर वन इज फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर कम्स. लुक एट व्हाट हेल्थ एंड वेलफेयर मिनिस्टर सेज. या ना प्लीज वेट अ मिनट, धीरे धीरे पढ़ लेने दे. ठीक है, सब अच्छी अच्छी बातें, वैसे ही माता के दिन चल रहे हैं तो जो है ना जो दारू पीने वाले हैं बेचारे वो भी जो है ना परेशान है. वो देख रहा है, आई विल टॉक टू योर फादर. वेल सो नेक्स्ट, ये सब जानते हो आप हैं, शराब बुरी चीज़ है, इससे शरीर और आत्मा का दोनों का नाश होता है और फैमिली गेट्स निग्लेक्टेड, ये वो सब. हॉस्टल में कौन कौन रहता है, पीजी में? हाँ नहीं नहीं तू तो बच्चा है. मेल नहीं नहीं आजकल, ओ सॉरी, आई एम टोल्ड दैट इन दिल्ली द सेल ऑफ वाइट लिकर ग्रोथ दैट इज वोदका एंड जिन इज फास्टर देन द सेल ऑफ द ट्रेडिशनल लिकर दैट इज विस्की. So I don't know what does that mean. That well, anyway, next please. Take it. So he has given all those arguments. Fine. Finally, last. So last one is. So health and welfare minister says, I am completely in favor of prohibition. This is one ministry says. Let's see what finance minister says. No, he is not also drinking. Kabhi aap ye soch rahe ho. Yes. Look at this. Now try to understand on a more serious note. Sale of liquor is a source of revenue. And it's a major source of revenue. He has given certain figures. That 25% of the state revenue comes from sale of liquor only. Aapne prohibition kar di, 60,000 crore nahi aayenge. जब 60,000 नहीं आएंगे तो क्या होगा. नेक्स्ट प्लीज. या वी विल नॉट बी एबल टू डू दीज मैनी थिंग्स. 2,000 प्राइमरी हेल्थ सेंटर्स विल हैव टू बी क्लोज डाउन. रूरल एरिया खत्म करना पड़ेगा. ड्रिंकिंग वाटर फैसिलिटी फॉर 1,000 विलेजेस. दिस इज व्हाट द फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर इज सेइंग दैट देयर विल बी because of this, this is what I have to cut down. So he strongly opposes. Now my question is, what should, if you were Nitish Kumar, what would you do? This is interactive. No. Raise your hand. The rules of the game are, raise your hand, ask, speak only when you are asked to. Who is right and who is wrong? देखो हाथ खड़े करके बोलना है, ऐसे नहीं बोलना. घबराओ नहीं, कुछ नहीं होगा. कम ऑन है वो कर दिया, चलो फिर नहीं. द क्वेश्चन हियर इज वेदर प्रोहिबिशन शुड बी इम्पोज्ड और नॉट. या नो, लेट्स नॉट गेट इनटू द पॉलिटिक्स और एनीथिंग. माय क्वेश्चन इज सिंपल. There are only two answers. Prohibition should be imposed or prohibition should not be imposed. Now, yes? Which means health minister is wrong. Wo bhi sahi hai, wo bhi sahi hai. Finance minister jyada sahi hai. Kyon? है? ये अपनी, देखो तुम अपनी व्यथा शाम को मेरे को बता देना. मैं ईमेल आईडी फोन नंबर आपको दे के जाऊंगा. ये जो आपकी अपनी व्यथा आ रही है ना, इसको शाम को सॉर्ट आउट कर लेंगे. पॉइंट ऑफ दिस फ्रेंड्स My point of telling you this was simply, इससे पहले मैंने एक स्लाइड दिखाई थी, वो पढ़ी आपने? पीछे दिखा, लास्ट जो शुरू में जो था, साइंटिफिक एनालिसिस वाली, या Why did I tell you this case? What is it in which analysis the health minister is? Normative. When he is saying drinking is a social evil, drinking causes marital discord, family this thing this, what is he talking about? He is talking about a society, ideal society, free from the curse of drinking. Ideal society, what should be? Health minister's approach is normative in nature. On the other hand, what is the finance minister saying? That is positive analysis. He is opposing prohibition not because he wants to encourage drinking in the state. What he is trying to say? The trade-off part. That if you give up this, then this will be the loss. He is talking about, friends, the next skill that I want to tell you is, at the corporate level, do not think in terms of normative. Your analysis should always be positive. आप समाज को संसार को बदलने के लिए पैदा नहीं हुए हैं, उसके लिए और बहुत लोग हैं। आपका काम कॉरपोरेट में क्या है? वो गिवन सिचुएशन में, यस गिवन सिचुएशन में व्हाट इज द बेस्ट पॉसिबल ऑप्शन विदाउट बॉदरिंग अबाउट व्हाट इज आइडियल व्हाट इज डिजायरेबल. इज दैट क्लियर? एनी प्रॉब्लम एट द बैक? ओके फाइन. ने Next thing, faster please, you can go ahead further. Thoda sa fast develop. Yes, next please. Yeah, another thing. This is a simple one, all of you must be knowing it, that whenever you plan a strategy, you should always jot down the benefits from that strategy. Say, if there are three alternatives to do it, so alternative A, B, C, A ke benefits kya hai, B ke benefits kya hai, C ke benefits kya hai. Similarly, along with benefits, there will be some costs. The cost you jot down, and then what you do, which one will you pick up, in which the difference between the two is the largest. Marginal equivalency rule simply says that as long as the benefit of doing an action is greater than the cost involved in that action, keep doing it. आपको एक काम करने में 200 रुपए मिलते हैं, 180 रुपए उसकी कॉस्ट आती है, व्हाट इज योर मार्जिनल बेनिफिट? 20 रुपीज. कंटिन्यू डूइंग दैट, मैक्सिमाइजिंग बिहेवियर फॉर द कॉर्पोरेट. दैट इज अनदर वेरी मेजर प्रॉब्लम वी फाइंड एट द टाइम ऑफ कैंपस रिक्रूटमेंट. आप लोग जब उनके वहां एक कंपनियां आके प्री प्लेसमेंट टॉक देती हैं, प्री प्लेसमेंट टॉक, एक तो आपकी ये बड़ी स्टैंडर्ड वो है कि कंपनी फ्लोट हुई और शुरू से वो कंपनी अपने इंट्रोडक्शन देती है, आगे देती है, जेडी क्या एक्सपेक्टेशन है, वो सब कुछ नहीं देखते मोबाइल में, यूं यूं देखेंगे नीचे 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 नीचे. CTC 6.5 दाब दे, अपील होना है, कुछ नहीं. CTC 6.5 लाख, नो, pre-placement talk mein, and this has actually happened in our institute. Several times, year after year, it happens. What do you do? Recruiters simply say ke hum PPT jab kar rahe the, nobody was listening to what we are and what kind of skills we want. Your students were simply asking the breakdown of the 6.5 lakh CTC. Mere ko haath mein kitna aayega? There is nothing called free lunch, friends. Aap ye socho ke aap company ko kya doge? You will earn only when the organization earns. You will be recruited once you show concern. We keep telling you time and again to read about the company. Not only the company, about its rivals also. Read about the job that requirement is there and how do you fit in that. So, shareholders' wealth increasing is your sole objective. उस कंपनी के मालिकों की शेयर होल्डर्स की वेल्थ बढ़ाना आपका ऑब्जेक्टिव. और पर्सनल उसमें भी आप हमेशा क्या करते हो? यू लुक एट गेन. व्हाट इज योर गेन? वी ऑलवेज, ऑल ऑफ अस आर इन दिस रैट रेस ऑफ मैक्सिमाइजिंग आवर ओन यूटिलिटी फंक्शंस, आवर ओन गेन्स, मैक्सिमाइजिंग बिहेवियर. Now, if I tell you that you should always look forward to maximizing your personal gain and or organizational gain, this I will tell you with a caveat, with a kind of warning. What is that warning? Next, please. Yeah. Wait a minute. There is a concept called absolute gain. And there's another concept called relative gain. Do you know the difference between the two? Absolute gain and relative gain. Well, that's where the caselets are important. I'll give you a simple caselet, small caselet. Next, please. Yeah, hold on here. Suppose your boss calls you in his office. And he offers you the following two options. Pehla option, 10% increase in your salary and 100% increase in the salary of all the colleagues with which you are working in the same designation and category. Option number two, nobody gets any increase in salary. Well, the punchline comes. Next, please. जल्दी नहीं करना. मैनेजमेंट में हमेशा जो है ना, एक दिल से मत सोचना, थोड़ा दिमाग लगाओ. Remember always, the most innocuous questions, जितना harmless question लगे उतना ही difficult है जवाब देना. आप कॉलर खड़े करके इंटरव्यू में जाते हो, सर आई हैव डन स्पेशलाइजेशन इन मार्केटिंग. द जेंटलमैन ऑन द अदर साइड ऑफ द टेबल सिंपली आस्क्ड, वेल जेंटलमैन कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट इज मार्केटिंग? सर मार्केटिंग इज नॉट अबाउट सेलिंग अलोन, दिस थिंग ब्ला ब्ला वो. नो, आप ट्राई कभी, आप क्या कहते हैं इसको, सिमुलेशन एक्सरसाइज करके देखिए. जितने सिंपल क्वेश्चन होंगे, इंट्रोड्यूस योर सेल्फ. 50 साल हो गए मेरे को खुद इसका जवाब नहीं मिल रहा कि इंट्रोड्यूस क्या करें. स्पेशलाइजेशन, आई एम ए स्पेशलिस्ट इन. नो, ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट. फर्स्ट रिमेंबर द रूल्स आर सिंपल टू प्ले दिस. ओके, लेट अस पुट इट टू वोट फर्स्ट. आजकल वोट का जमाना चल रहा है, सीजन चल रहा है. लेट्स फाइंड आउट हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू विल गो फॉर ऑप्शन वन. Raise your hands, please. Those who will go for option one. How many? Achhi tarah, clearly raise your hands. Nobody here? Yeah, yeah. Come on. Soch rahe hai abhi. Very few. Oh, okay. No. एंड ऑप्शन टू बाकी कहां गए. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ मैनेजर्स आर यू इफ यू कांट डिसाइड. कोई इंटरनल असेसमेंट नहीं कटेगी. बताइए आप. सम टाइम आई डू आई मीन इन ए स्मॉलर लॉट आई डू इज आई क्लियरली डिमार्केट पीपल दैट ऑप्शन वन वाले इधर आ जाओ ताकि कोई जो ना मतलब क्रॉस वोटिंग का चांस ना हो और इधर आ जाओ. एनीवे ऑप्शन वन समवन रेज्ड ए हैंड एट द बैक. यस आई लाइक बैक बेंचेस. पीछे किसी ने हाँ यही कहीं यस कैन टेल मी व्हाई. या नो और पीछे या दैट गर्ल ओके या समथिंग इज बेटर देन नथिंग शी सेज सो आई एम गेटिंग 10% फाइन आई एम फाइन विद यू. एनीवन हु वांट्स टू ऐड टू दैट फ्रॉम ऑप्शन वन सपोर्टर्स. या किसी के पास कोई थर्ड सॉल्यूशन भी है क्या और इनोवेटिव हो मुझे नहीं पता है. हाँ इसमें मैं आपको पहले बता दूं ए दिस इज ए ऑफर विच हैज बीन गिवन देयर एंड देन. आप बॉस को ये नहीं कह सकते. कुछ राती लड़के सोच रहे होंगे कि भाई बॉस 10 मिनट का टाइम दो अभी वापस जाते हैं अपने हॉल में वो 9 कोलीग्स के साथ मांडली करके आते हैं कि इतने परसेंट हमें दे देगा तो बेटा तुम्हें जो ना 100% दिलवा देता हूं. नो एंड यू कैन नॉट टेल आउटसाइड किसी को कोई विश्वास भी नहीं. अच्छा दूसरी बात ये बॉस के सामने आप रोना धोना नहीं करेंगे कि सर ये क्यों कर रहे हो मेरे साथ मैं तो इतना एफिशिएंट रहा हूं ये वो सब कुछ नहीं. सिंपल है टेक इट और लीव इट फाइन. यस ऑप्शन टू या तू तो ऋषिकेश चला जाए यार. कॉर्पोरेट में क्यों आया तू. हेमकुंड साहब ऋषिकेश हूज ग्रोथ. यहां पे आप अपने आप क्यों एज्यूम कर रहे हो सब कुछ. आपको सिंपल ऑफर दिया है बॉस ने और वो मैटर वहीं 5 मिनट में खत्म हो जाएगा. सो डू नॉट एड एनीथिंग टू. आपको दो ऑप्शन दिए गए हैं. कोई ना बॉस डिस्कस करेगा इस बात को बाहर ना आप करोगे. आप करोगे भी तो आपका विश्वास कोई नहीं करेगा. सिंपल बात है. यस ऑप्शन टू कम ऑन. इतने लोगों ने हाथ खड़ा किया था क्या हुआ. कम ऑन लेट अस बी इंटरेक्टिव प्लीज ओन अप. हु आर ऑन ऑप्शन टू यस Why? Yeah, a traditional female jealousy. So simple, hai? Adhogi. Yeah. Yeah. Be more specific. That's very nice. Yeah. किसकी ये कहीं किस में लिखा हुआ है केसलेट में. कुछ नहीं लिखा हुआ है केसलेट में. जितनी इंफॉर्मेशन दी हुई है केस में जितनी इंफॉर्मेशन दी हुई उसी को आप यूज कर सकते हैं. यस या ओके एंड दैट इज व्हाट यू फील. That is what you feel. Eh? Yeah, that is what you think. So say it in a different manner. I would have said, yeah. So as comparison. Yeah. In fact, it would have been even better Let us take an example. Before going to the boss's cabin, all 10 of you were drawing, say, 50,000 salary. Same colleague, same category, 50,000 sabki salary thi. Aapne option 1 le liya. Next salary check aapka kitna aayega? 55. Aapke baaki 9 colleagues ka. That is what she was saying. She was not forthright in saying it. Why should I? You know, the previous slide, what I said, the previous slide, there are two types of gains. One is absolute gain, another is relative gain. Friends, never ever think in terms of absolute gains alone in the corporate world. Because there you do not live in isolation. This is also very important. Not only it is important that how much you grow, it is also important how much is your rival growing. It's a relative world. So, sometime as a corporate strategy, you have to bear certain temporary losses in order to inflict a bigger loss on your rival. Could you get my point? Relatively, you will be better off. Aapko kam nuksan hua, hamare Haryana mein ek kavat hai, ki apni chai diwar gir jaye, padosi ki bhains jarur marni chahiye. Simple. Diwar ka kya hai? Chune se bani hui hai, gaare se, dobara khadi kar lenge. Uski 1 lakh ki bhains jaan. Relatively, that is very important. This is another strategy that you have to take in mind. Compare between absolute gain to the company or to yourself and the relative gain. If the relative gain is smaller, forego absolute gain. That is what I am trying to say. Fine. Next, please. Yeah. Well, these are again simple ones. That this is a very important thing though. Hum log kai baar jo hai na ye hota hai, even with our faculty members also, sometime it happens. We go to the director criticizing the existing arrangement, existing system. The director will, or my chairman will simply ask me, what is the alternative? So, unless you have an alternative plan, do not ever try to criticize. This happens at your young age very much. First job mein ye bada common hoga aapke saath. Ki aapko lagega ye sab bekar 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 ho raha hai. And sometimes you keep criticizing. The senior HR manager will think, ya ek aad baar aapko sunne ko bhi milega. अभी चुपचाप बैठ जा, तू बच्चा है, ऐसे करके. So try to think over it, what the existing structure is, try to find out, read it, analyze it, why it is there, and if you find something wrong in it, then you must also find out what is the plan to change it. That is what I am trying to say. The next one is, okay, this is another thing. Aap ek plan leke gaye boss ke paas, and boss ne immediately reject kar di, ya usme koi major flaw tha. Then, what will you do? But you haven't thought of that. So, always carry an alternative in your hip pocket. A plan B, so that he can think that, yes, he has done some work. That is what I am trying to say. Well, finally, next please. Yeah, this is another thing. Normally, humne dekha hai ke aap apne jo co-worker ke saath koi bahut innovative idea hai na, akele mein share mat karo kabhi bhi. Chahe kitna hi achha best friend ho aapki. Aapka ya aapki. Sometime it so happens, you feel very bad. That chap tells this idea to the boss and takes the credit. And then you feel very, very bad. So always disclose an innovative idea in a group, in a bigger meeting. That is a practical strategy hai. Galat bhi ho sakte hai, immoral bhi ho sakte hai. Because finally I'm coming on to the ethical aspect of my lecture. Yeah. What do you understand by ethics and how much role do they play in the corporate world? Yes? No? Maybe? Have you got those? I'll send a caselet. Can you distribute that, please? Yeah. We have another 15 minutes. I'll distribute a caselet with you. Read this. And then we'll discuss it, the ethical aspect. No, no, question paper nahi hai, ghabrao nahi. This is an abridged version, so read it carefully because it's much smaller. The actual case study was much bigger. I've just reduced it to a single page. But all essential details are here. Well, those who have read the case, please plan your line of action. What could be the, what would be your response? You can jot down your answer. It helps if you write down certain points. Initially, you normally tend to forget speaking extempore. Okay, I think the discomfort level is increasing. 11 baje chai ka time hota hai. Acha 11 baje chhod dunga. Positive. 11 baje se pehle bhi nahi chhodunga. Tum mera dhanyavad karne mein kitna time lagaoge? 1 minute. Koi ye bhi problem hoti hai na baad mein, koi vote of thanks wanks jo hai na kuch. Okay, I'll give you, since I think जिसने पढ़ना था पढ़ लिया है, I'll give you three alternatives हैं इसमें, आपने देखे ही होंगे कि one, एक या धीरे धीरे सारा सस्पेंस ही खत्म कर देते, कंसंट्रेशन नहीं बनती बेटा. हाँ नहीं नहीं फर्स्ट those who are for this do as the boss has asked you to do, forget any moral or ethical dilemma. Yeah, very nice. Bas Singh sahab toda hath nahi khada hoya, ha zabardasti karwana pada, sanu ki lena dena, boss ne aakya karange aap. Bas itna hi. My God, इतने संत ज्ञानी कहां से आ गए. Number two, how many are there? ये क्या indecisive लोग बहुत ज्यादा हैं क्या? Because when I ask for hands, the total, the sigma of all the options is less than 10%, 20%, 80% are simply silent. What or what? You are waiting for option third. What could that be? आपने केस पढ़ा है, उसमें लिखा हुआ है, हैं? Talk to the manager. Give her a big hand. Good. Yeah, third one. Option three. Okay, you will have to be. हाँ. So. All of you are thinking in terms of option 3, and I'm surprised that in option 1 there are very few of them. The problem, the ethical dilemma is, you know, it's a very very touchy line. In fact, I find it very difficult to decide myself. The ethical dilemma can be, because sometime you will find those who want to go in option 1. Why? Let's listen to them first. Yeah. Okay. So. Okay. Yes. So he says, my ethics will change as I change my companies. Company ne ye kaha hai to main karunga, dusri company jo kahegi. So the ethics of an individual employee should be in tune with the ethics of the company. Oh, this is interesting. I'll have to think over it. Well, that is what he's saying. Yes. Those who are in favor of quitting. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. There is an alternative also. Some of you, if you have read that case, it says, some of the answers that came in my class earlier on was that since the economic condition is bad, job condition is bad, somewhere it is written, and if I quit this, I may not get this offer elsewhere. So for the time being, I'll take up option one, do as the company says, which means your ethics will change according to the economic condition. The problem with ethics is it is a very, very thin line. How far or thus far, no further. There is no cut and dried answer. In fact, the third one is no answer, incidentally. Talk to the bosses. Okay. Let's see, because a large number of you said talk to the bosses. What kya hoga boss se baat kar, senior se bypass karke senior se baat kar li. Wo theek hai. Nahi aapne aap third one kya hai? With what, with whom? HR head. Fir usse kya hoga? This is another thing. Sometime we study this, another thing. Should you bypass your immediate boss? Is it a good corporate strategy to bypass the immediate boss? No. Particularly in internship. Nobody will like that incident. Anyway, yeah. Can say senior boss in sir. Incidentally, let me tell you, if you read that case, perhaps one thing you have not seen. Aap ye soch rahe ho ke aapne rivals ko ye bata ke phone kar diya ke main falan falan institute ki intern hu. To kya rival company aapko information de degi? Nobody will. In fact, in this case, it makes a perfect sense to use the first strategy also. Because in any case, this is an information and it's a very, very thin line. But one thing at the end I would like to tell you, sometime we say, and this used to be in India the condition, that ethics do not play any role in corporate life. No, that is not. Today there are IMF studies which say the companies who carry out their business transactions in an ethical manner, their profits have increased. So ethics is not something for the other world, it is for this world also. Ethics simply, in your case, limits to what? Promise what you can deliver. Deliver what you have promised. Check whether you have delivered what you promised or not. Simple. Never ever promise something which you cannot deliver. That is what ethics is about. But this is something which requires further tuning. I do not have a cut and dried answer to the last part of this, the role of ethics in corporate decision making. I leave it to you with this dilemma. And friends, it was wonderful talking to you. This is my homecoming. I started this institute in 1995 in 6 rooms in Rukmani Devi School. That is what your history is about. Later on, in about 5 years, we shifted to this place. And wonderful. Anshu, thank you for calling me. Thank you very much. Thanks. बेटा ये
Thank you, sir. The session was indeed informative and interactive. Your incisive analysis on the current techniques in the economy has a psychological impact on people, especially the youth. Your remarkable insights in explaining the economic situations have provided in-depth understanding of the effect of policy changes on a common man. Thank you, sir, for your contribution in reflecting true picture of the economy. Now I request Dean in Academics, Dr. Anshu Lochup, to kindly present a memento to sir as a token of remembrance. Once again, on behalf of our dais, we thank you for coming here and gracing this session. It was wonderful to hear from you, sir. Your messages have been noted down by us for further references and action. Once again, thank you everybody. Have a good day.